Hi, my name's Crispy. I'm a developer advocate on the CAST developer relations team. In this DevBytes video, I will discuss Google CAST receivers and how development works with CAST receiver devices. For this video, I'm assuming you're already familiar with the CAST developer console. If not, please review the developer console documentation. Now, let's take a look at what a receiver application is. CAST receiver applications are single-page HTML5 apps that are loaded from a network URL and executed on a special version of Chrome. CAST receiver applications run on CAST receiver devices, like a Chromecast. Elements such as buttons, links, and alerts have been disabled since there is no mouse or keyboard input available. All interactions with a running CAST receiver application happen through messages sent by a CAST sender app. To illustrate this interaction model, let's take a look at how a CAST receiver application is launched. CAST receiver applications are launched when a CAST sender application, running on a sender device, such as a phone, tablet, or computer, tells a receiver device that it wants to launch an application. What that application is depends on the application ID that the sender provides when requesting to use the receiver device. The receiver device will look up the application ID using a Google service and load the corresponding receiver application associated with it. Once the receiver application is loaded, it can start processing messages from the connected sender applications. As a developer, you have options when it comes to the type of receiver application launched by a sender. An application ID is a unique ID for a receiver application that you get when you register a receiver app in the CAST developer console. You can register an application ID at cast.google.com/publish. There are three types of receiver applications, two of which require registration using the CAST developer console and one that does not. The one that doesn't is called the default media receiver, and all it does is play simple media. No styling, no customization, and no application ID. There's no way to modify its behavior. The styled media receiver application does require registration and allows for some customization. It's for playback of simple media. More on this in a moment. Custom receivers are applications that require registration and are for building advanced media players on or other types of TV applications like games. A styled media receiver allows a sender application to play media on a CAST device without needing to create your own custom receiver application. You can customize the styled media receiver color scheme and branding by providing your own CSS during registration. The styled media receiver is a great way to get started building Google CAST applications. Using the styled media receiver means developers can focus their efforts on sender application interactions without having to build a custom receiver. Creating a styled media receiver is as easy as registering for an application ID through the CAST developer console. The styled media receiver is the best option if the application does not need to utilize advanced media playback capabilities such as adaptive streaming, DRM, closed captioning, or authentication. Custom receiver applications are the way to go if you want to have control over all aspects of the behavior of your application. With custom receivers, you can support protocol namespaces beyond just media and build rich experiences for your users. You have full control over the presentation, interactions, and more. Using the Google CAST Receiver SDK, you can build an HTML5 application, hook into the various events that are fired within the CAST Receiver message system, and build complex behaviors beyond simple media playback. The CAST Receiver APIs provide ways for developers to build rich applications targeting the TV space. You can utilize the CAST Media Player library to build media applications that use adaptive streaming, HLS, MPEG-Dash, smooth streaming, and more. They can also handle authentication and use DRM. In order to load a receiver application onto a CAST device while developing, register the receiver devices you wish to use in the CAST developer console. For an unpublished receiver application, only registered CAST devices will be able to load the receiver application. As well, during development, the receiver device will need to expose its serial number. This can be enabled using the Chromecast setup application. Simply select the CAST device and enable the Send Serial Number when checking for updates option. When you publish your application, any CAST receiver device can load your app. Now that I've covered some of the basics of setting up for development, let's have a look at some code. In a few lines of code, a very basic custom receiver application can be built that plays simple media. First, we load the receiver APIs. Then, we ensure that we have a video element, some media element to playback video, music, etc. Once the window onload is fired, identify the media element and create a CAST media manager to handle the sender communication and media events. Then, get an instance of the CAST receiver manager, which is responsible for communicating with the CAST system, and tell it to start, which lets the receiver device know that the application is loaded and ready to process sender messages. From here, you can build up additional application logic, As you do, you might want to know how to debug your receiver code. Thankfully, it's very simple to debug receiver applications. You can connect to a device debugger on a registered receiver by opening Chrome on a computer and going to the IP address of the receiver device on port 9222. You can get the IP address of the receiver device using the Chromecast setup app. The debugger has full DOM manipulation and JavaScript console support. To keep logs between sessions, click the gear icon in the lower right and check the box next to Preserve Log Upon Navigation. We are very excited to see what you build with Google Cast. To get you going, we are providing a number of resources. You can discover more details about the Google Cast SDK at developers.google.com/cast. The design checklist will go a long way in guiding you down the path to creating great second screen applications. You can find sample senders and sample receiver apps at github.com/googlecast. Post your questions on Stack Overflow and tag them with Google-Cast. In future DevBytes, we will dive deeper into the Cast Sender SDK for each platform and Cast Receiver SDK. Join the Google Cast developer community on Google+ for pro tips and share your experiences. It's now up to you to go out and create great Google Cast receiver applications. Happy casting!